Before we start, shout out to Black Velvet Coffee. They're up in Mammoth Mountain, California. Super great coffee. Great mug. I like it. It's one of my favorite mugs. Hey, yo, what's up, guys? Zaid here with another episode of Zaid's Experience. So today's finally the day. Today, I have completed my 90 days of carnivore, and I wanted to share those results with you guys. So if you guys are thinking about me doing a carnivore diet or trying it out for a couple of weeks, this is the video for you. This is what you can expect. I'm gonna share with you guys my results. That way you guys know what to expect for your experience. So come with me and let's check these out. So first of all, for all of you guys that don't know what a carnivore diet is and you just happen to find this video, what a carnivore diet is essentially eating all red meat or animal products. What do these include? Eggs, pork, chicken, red meat, whatever you can find as long as it's an animal product at the least process possible, if any processing. So that's technically what a carnivore diet is. It keeps it super simple, super to the point, and that's what I did for these past 90 days. I've also done another carnivore diet challenge and I tried that out. So if you guys wanna go ahead and check that video out as well, I'll leave a card up here. That way you guys can check that video out as well. But these are the results for this carnivore diet. This is the second time around that I've done this carnivore diet. So what have been my findings this time around on the carnivore diet? Well, there's definitely been some improvements as to the things that I've tweaked for the better. And there's definitely some things that I found along the way that didn't work as well the second time around that I thought were definitely gonna work, but kind of backfired. I mean, you live, you learn, right? At the beginning of this 90 days of carnivore, as many of you guys know, if you've been watching this channel for any amount of time, I have a couple of injuries, and there's a couple of the older injuries that have come back due to some work-related things. So I have two shoulder injuries. I got one on my right shoulder. That's the primary one that keeps on bothering me. And then the left one is still there. It happened that same day at work. And then some hip stuff started to come back and knee thing started to come back as well. Those are some of the issues, and I can't talk a lot more about those because there's kind of some legal action involved in all of this, but we'll put all those aside. Because of those issues, I wasn't able to exercise as much as I would like to. Actually, all exercising has been stopped for like the past almost 60 days, which has really hindered my performance in this carnivore diet, or the way I was expecting to do it the second time around. As I've mentioned before, I said that I was gonna include Greek yogurt and honey, and so I wanted to give those a shot with all the workouts that I was gonna do, with my running, with maybe just going out to the gym and working out. I thought those were gonna really help me out, take it to the next level, but due again to these things that started to come out, I couldn't work out, so I had to drop that, and I haven't been able to do any exercise. I haven't been able to do much at all, and so that was one of the things that kind of backfired, and so I had to drop that after like the 30th, 40th day. I had to drop the honey and that for just completely. So that was one of my big things that kind of backfired. It was just, I couldn't have foreseen it, you know? The injuries got a little bit worse, and things happen. So another thing that backfired that I thought wasn't gonna backfire as much was my weight loss. I thought this time around I was gonna lose a little bit more weight, which I did. I did lose some weight, but it's more visible to me than it is on a scale, which is the trippy part. And I'll show you guys the scale right now in a little while. So I know a lot of people wanna see, how do you look physically, and has anything changed? Has your weight changed? I did put on some muscle. Again, my body for some reason doesn't wanna let go of fat, but it is more than willing to put on muscle like it's nobody's problem. If I started working out today again, I literally start to get super big like this. This is after not doing anything some time now, for some months now. And I don't feel like I need to work out a lot to retain muscle, but I definitely need to work out in order to take some of my body fat off. My body just wants to hover around that 193. to 198 body weight, no matter if it's fat, no matter if it's muscle, it just wants to stay there. It just feels perfectly fine there. So I wanted to give you guys a kind of a list of the pros and cons that doing the carnivore diet will help you out with, or the things that I have found by doing this carnivore diet. And I'm gonna give you the list of the cons first. So the basic thing is adapting. The adaptation phase is crap. It is utter and complete crap. It's really, really hard. If you've come from a background where you've never done something like a keto diet or really incorporated high amounts of fats into your diet, you will struggle. You will have a very hard time the first at least 15 to 30 days. It'll suck for you guys. So just, I'm giving you an FYI. Those 30 days will be basically your body rebalancing and changing all the machinery necessary in order to go from using carbs as energy to using fats as energy. So that process takes a while. How long does it take? Depends completely on the individual. It depends on a bunch of little things. For me, it actually took the first time around, it took me about 45 days to adapt. That's how bad my body was wrecked back then. Until like the 45th day, I kind of felt decent enough to be like, okay, things are kind of stabilizing. I felt the effects of the carnivore diet that were like the cognition effect. You start feeling those within the first like 5 to 10 days really quickly, but the energy levels will pretty much suck up until you fully get adapted, and you guys will definitely notice it. If you guys do any kind of exercising, this will be the hardest part for you, because you will notice that the first couple of days you will slowly start to kind of be drained. You're gonna feel like the life force is being sucked out of you. There's kind of no simpler way of putting it. So give it some time though. Be mindful and give it some time. Your body is switching up fuel sources, so it will take some time. As I mentioned, this second time around is a little bit more fat adapted, so I didn't deal with as much of that this second time around. But what I did deal with was the typical cravings. The first 15 days, when you just drop sugar, when you just drop carbs, you are definitely gonna feel that you're gonna wanna just eat the world. You're gonna, anything you see, you're gonna wanna eat it, especially if it's sugar-based. If you see a donut, if you see a chocolate shake, if you see anything, if you see a fruit, it'll be the best looking fruit of your life, even if it looks all crappy, moldy, and it's like dying away. Like, you wanna take a bite out of it. It's insane. So that's gonna be a pretty tough part if you guys are doing this for the first time. Your first 15 days are your ticket of entry. If you get past those 15 days, you're pretty much gonna be solid. You will be able to plow through the entire thing after that. It's just the first 15 days, I think, that really kind of kill you. Another thing that's a little, that happens to a lot of people is they either get constipated or they get extreme diarrhea. Yes, extreme diarrhea. In my case, I usually get diarrhea when I first start doing it, and it's not that extreme, and it's just because you're consuming a lot more fat than you're usually consuming, and so a lot of people get constipated sometimes, and some people have the complete opposite effect. Some people just get extreme, yeah. Those are technically the two things, and if you are having a lot of problems with that, I think some people have recommended using digestive enzymes. I personally haven't tried them. I hear they really, really help you out with all this, so maybe give them a shot if you are suffering from diarrhea, if you're going through your first 15 days. And that could definitely, potentially help you out. Another con that I noticed since I told you guys that I was gonna add those extra 30 grams of carbs a day with the Greek yogurt and the honey to help me power through my running, I did notice it. I was very happy in the first 30 days doing that. I felt that I actually was losing weight quite fast. I was doing a good amount of exercise and my body was doing great. But unfortunately, the whole hip thing happened. It flared up and then I had to just stop. I couldn't even run. And then right after that, I had to stop because of my knee. So all that kind of just happened. But if you guys are thinking about doing extremely heavy exercises, like I'm talking really demanding cardio, I highly suggest you keep a little bit of carbs in. I know some people will say, no, well, you can just eat a lot more, you know, eat a lot more nutrient dense stuff like organ meats and just a lot more food, maybe eat 4 times a day or something like that. There's still a component that cannot be filled. It's really, really tough. Maybe somebody has found a way to do it, and if you guys have found a way to do it throughout all carnivore, please let me know down in the comment section. but I haven't found a way to do extreme cardio and strength training with the carnivore diet without feeling completely depleted and even lightheaded. So keeping those carbs in at the very beginning really helped me out, and I think that was the perfect balance for me. And if I ever start doing the whole running thing again, plus my workouts, plus my work, then I really think that I'm gonna keep that small amount of carbs in. I know there's a couple of professional triathlete runners that are starting to do carnivore diets, and that's the way that they do it. They do mostly all carnivore, and they put small amounts of carbs in, and given they're just burning carbs like crazy, they're burning calories like crazy. So even thinking about just doing all carnivore is insane, but the fact that these athletes are able to do it on carnivore and just like a small amount of carbs after that is crazy. It tells you a lot. But even they have to keep the carbs in. I mean, I'm not doing anything closely related to the amount of hours that they do throughout the day, but as far as explosiveness, as far as strength, and as far as conditioning, it gets pretty close at some points. So the recap on that is, again, guys, if you guys are doing anything that's super explosive, say CrossFit, say sprints, like massive sprints for an hour or something like that, you know, make sure that you do take a couple of carbs, grams of carbs, and it will help you out, or it will deplete you for a long period of time, which is what I noticed the first time around. I noticed that it just depleted me the first day, second day even more, and it just goes by a little bit. It's like you try to bring your levels up and then it just hits you down, and then it just keeps on going this like a weird ladder. But other than that, I really don't see any cons with this carnivore diet. Maybe the only other thing would be that it's a little bit of a mundane diet. And what do I mean by that? I mean, you get eggs in your diet, you get chicken, you get red meat, which includes pork and beef. So it's not that mundane of a diet. It's just what you do with all those things. You really can make it a little bit more interesting. Just do realize that when you guys are going into this, it is gonna be a little mundane at one point, and that would be about the only other con. But other than that, everything else was a pro in my opinion. Now, for some of the pros, mental clarity. Yes, in the first 5 to 7 days, you'll start experiencing some crazy mental clarity, which I did experience the second time around once again. And then for some reason, it kind of goes away, and then it comes back like in the 15th to 20 day, and it stays kind of permanent. So mental clarity is a yes. The diarrhea, the explosive diarrhea, or just diarrhea in general, stops happening. So that's always a plus, like around the 15th, 20th day when your body starts kind of getting used to it. So yeah, it's a long list of pros, guys. I actually jotted some of these things down. I've always had extreme insulin resistance, so that was one of the reasons that also pushed me to do this carnivore diet once again. I knew that if I kept on eating carbs, that wasn't gonna help the problem at all. So insulin resistance got a lot better. My insulin levels, I think, managed to get to a normal. My gut health got a lot better. One of the ways I found that out was a lot of things started to resolve themselves all over my body, and that's usually due to your gut health. One of the things that I started noticing immediately, my skin started glowing once again. It has this really awkward glow. Actually, I wouldn't say awkward. It's a really nice glow that it starts getting. And people kind of started asking. People started noticing, hey, what's going on? You look good today. I would get that a lot more. Another thing that started happening, bloating went away. Bloating completely goes away with this carnivore diet. That's one of the big things that gets fixed. I talked about it a lot before. I used to get bloated all the time, and now I never get bloated at all, period. If I'm in this carnivore diet, it just doesn't happen. Water weight was another thing. I used to hold a lot of water weight because of the carbs. Now I just don't hold any water weight. Like, I can definitely see it, and the way I see it is I start getting a lot more definition in my muscles very easily. Another thing that I started noticing, my hair started growing in like super thick, super, super thick. And I noticed it, especially here in the beard. My beard used to fall off all the time. It used to fall off fairly quickly. Like, I would go like this and maybe I'd pull like one or two hairs. Now I pull nothing. I also used to lose a lot of hair, like from up here for a long period of time. I thought, you know what? It kind of sucks taking a shower and then seeing all the hair there, and it worries you, or at least it worried me. And I used to think, hey, is is this normal? Is this something that should happen? Should I be losing this amount of hair? And I've realized it very recently that no, you shouldn't be losing that amount of hair, or a big amount of hair. So if you guys are losing big amounts of hair, definitely consult it with a doctor or see what they would have to say about it. But I don't lose any hair anymore. I lose very, very small amounts. Like I can pull like 2-3 hairs, and that's about it. This might be something a little weird, and I don't know if this is just me or I'm going insane or something like that, but if anybody's experienced this, please let me know. I don't get sunburned anymore as much. Like it takes a lot for me to actually get sunburned. I've noticed this because on the weekends I have a weekend gig that I'm usually like just fully exposed to the sun, and my job also demands me to be under the sun all the time. As you guys can see, I'm considerably white from here, but from here I'm considerably darker. Like you guys can see this, and this is just because of what my job kind of entails. I've been on 100 degrees, 100 plus degrees sun fairly consistently. I haven't gotten sunburned at all. I don't even get spots. It's kind of creepy. And I started noticing this the first time around and I didn't think much of it. But the second time around I said, huh, I really noticed it, because from November up until the point where I started the second time of carnivore, I saw that I started to get sunburned quite a bit throughout those months where I wasn't doing it. And then once I started to do the carnivore diet again, it just so happened to land on the hottest months out of the entire year. And in those months, I haven't noticed any sunburns at all, and I don't use anything for my skin. So let me know in the comment section if you guys have experienced anything like that, or if you guys have found any research on that, or anybody else that has gone through the same experience. Please let me know down there. That's something that I kind of have to look into a little bit more. Consistent energy is a given. You're gonna have consistent energy once you go over that bump where your body kind of fully acclimatizes, I think, to the carnivore diet or using fats as energy. You're gonna have consistent energy throughout your day. If you guys had midday crashes, like around in the afternoon, like there is a part that is normal about that, but if you guys are just getting like completely epic crashes and just passing out, that's not normal. You guys need get that taken care of. You might have a mineral deficiency, you might have a vitamin deficiency, something is missing, but you guys shouldn't feel that crash. All that goes away with this carnivore diet, especially if you're including organ meats. That's the other big thing. Organ meats are gonna make a huge difference, guys. I found that halfway through the first time around, and I didn't include as much organ meats as I would have liked to, but I did include a lot more organ meats this second time around, and I definitely felt the advantages. So getting in some good organ meats is definitely gonna help you guys out. Mental function, you'll be a lot more mentally agile. You're gonna feel a lot better overall. You're gonna feel, I wouldn't say happier, but you're gonna feel a lot more relaxed. So that's something that you will notice. That's the best thing, I think. Whenever I come off of this diet, what I've noticed is that, let's say you didn't like the carnivore diet at all, but you tried it out for the first 30 days and you were like, you know what, it's just not for me. Once you start reintroducing your foods, even if you're kind of mentally lying to yourself up here that something just didn't jive with you, even though it did, but or maybe you can't keep up that lifestyle, that's perfectly fine. Once you start putting in the foods that were messing you up before, you're gonna get some extreme pushback from your body. Your body's gonna tell you, no, wait 1 second. If you had a lactose intolerance, you're gonna notice it very, very quickly, guys. If some greens just weren't jiving with you, you're gonna feel it. If you guys were eating like a bunch of processed stuff, you're gonna definitely feel it. Some people start to get acne all of a sudden and they're like, oh yeah, I stopped doing the carnivore diet and I started getting acne. Well, it's because you probably start eating something that you never should have like eaten in the first place. And now that your body's kind of in this state where everything was perfect, and then you just threw something completely off. Carts get me extremely bloated super quickly. Milk doesn't bother me as much, but I do start to see like my stomach get a little bloated. I retain a lot more water with milk, and I do get a couple of farts here and there. So that's definitely not a normal thing. So yeah, guys, I think those are the major takeaways here. There's a lot of things to be said. Oh, teeth health. That's the one I wanted to talk about as well. I know there's a lot of people that report a lot of health benefits in regards to your teeth. I noticed it the first time around that I wasn't getting as much plaque buildup, but the second time around, I really, really noticed it. Also, my teeth got a little bit whiter, which I'm really happy about. Maybe there wasn't as much staining happening. I don't know, I'm not a dentist, but that definitely happened. And the gum inflammation started to go away. So there you go, some more de-inflammation happening from your body. So the gum inflammation, I definitely noticed it, because you can definitely see in your gums, the color starts to change after a couple of weeks. And that's the one thing I won't show, guys. I'm a little particular about me showing my teeth. It's gonna look like a cow's feet. That's something I did definitely notice, guys. The inflammation in my teeth, my gums, was a lot better. So super happy with that. I wasn't expecting that. Like I mentioned, I noticed it kind of the first time around, but I also know that Jordan Peterson also experienced some of that. He said that he had gums disease for the longest time, and then once he started getting on this carnivore diet, he went a year later to his dentist, and the dentist said that he couldn't find anything, that his teeth were perfectly normal, that they were on a great state. And so that I think that says a lot about how little we understand the things that we think we understand right now. So leave a comment down there if you guys have noticed anything similar while being on this carnivore diet, or if you've heard about it. So if you guys are thinking about doing a carnivore diet, please consider maybe doing the carnivore diet to get healthy first, and then picking your precise goal as to if you are gonna gain some muscle, what are the steps that you need to do in order for that to happen. If you are gonna lose weight, what are the steps that you need to do in order for that to happen. But first, get healthy, and I think it takes like at least 30 to 60 days. I know it's rough to hang in there, but I think it's well worth it. But enough with all this, let me show you some of the physical results that I've gotten with all this carnivore diet madness.
It's wrong by 10 pounds.
Babe, it's wrong?
Yes.
No, babe, you gained weight. Nah, you can't.
So it's finally time for the weigh-in. Right, Willie? So let's see how we do. So there you go. 194. And it's saying all this other stuff.
Willie. 18% fat, 55 bone, 45% muscle, apparently like 10% calf because he won't eat me.
Really? So I actually went up in weight, guys. Now it's going to be good.
I know a lot of people won't be particularly impressed, especially with this upper section, but I'll talk about that a little bit later. But as far as I'm concerned, I lost quite a bit over here on the sides. So there you have it, guys. For me, it isn't easy to show you guys this. And although I didn't lose as much weight as I wanted to lose, or I don't look exactly the way that I wanted to look, I think that progress is being made. And at the end of the day, I think that's the most important thing for me. Progress is being made, and it's being made without doing any exercise, which is kind of the insane part. Again, these past 60 days, I haven't done any exercising, and it's killing me. It really is killing me. So I hope this all gets resolved pretty quickly. So what are some other things that I've learned with this carnivore diet? I think that it's a great way to bring your biomarkers down to a normal level and start the healing process of all the crap that we've probably been eating for God knows how many years, or ever since you've probably been alive, you know? How many kids do you see eating Eggos, cereal, or the cafeteria food that they serve at schools? It's just not healthy. So for me, I know for sure that I've never done something as regimented as this, as the carnivore diet for 90 days. And I think that by doing such a diet, it's a good reset for the body. I do still think that this is a major reset for the body, and I think it will work for most people. But for whatever the reason, physically I can't seem to demonstrate all those things, and even though I do follow the diet, for some reason the weight doesn't want to come off. That got me thinking on a couple of things, is what could I have done differently this time around to have gotten maybe a little bit better results, because I wasn't happy with those pictures at all, as much as I tried kind of convincing myself, hey, you know what, I did everything in my power to kind of lose that weight with all the restrictions that I had. Again, no exercise as of right now, so that kind of sucks. And as far as eating meat, well, I mean, there's no carbs there. What the hell? Yeah, I was definitely not happy with the results from those pictures, but obviously in my blood work I can definitely see the improvements being made. So I'm happy with the results of my blood work, with the results of where my brain is, where my inflammation has gone, how everything has progressed, except the fat loss. And I think that's where it's finally getting to me, and I think I'm finally have the recipe to do something to start shedding off all that excess fat. And in the next couple of weeks, you guys are gonna see a new video. It's gonna be a little bit of a different challenge, where I'm gonna be showing you guys what I'm gonna be doing to drop all those extra pounds. And it's gonna be, I think, a pretty interesting 30 days that I'm gonna be taking in. And then if I see the progress actually being made, which I'm pretty sure is gonna happen, then I'm gonna take it to 60 days. And if 60 days looks even better, then I'm gonna take it to 90 days. But I'm gonna also need some of your guys' support, so stick around for that. But in any case, guys, thanks for joining me on another episode of Zaid's Experience. Hope you guys like this video. Please go ahead, comment, like, and subscribe. You guys know the deal. Push that notification bell if you guys haven't already done so, that way you guys get notified every time I come up with a video such as this. As of the day that I'm making this video, I finally got up to 1,000 subscribers and a couple of more. So I'm super stoked, super happy about that. And it's all thanks to you guys. So I really, really appreciate you guys. Those of you guys that have been with me from the beginning, I really, really appreciate it. And those of you guys who are still following me, it's really super awesome. You guys give me a why to continue to do this channel. And even though I sometimes might not succeed, I definitely feel that putting my struggle out there is not in vain when you guys are being this receptive. So I really thank all of you guys. But that is it for today, guys. Time to start planning out the next thing. So Zaid out.
Peace.